Five Investigates has obtained exclusive video that helped expose cases of workers' compensation fraud here in Massachusetts.
Our Mike Beaudet shows us people caught cheating the system and the court trying to resolve disputes.
Your Honor, this is our request to modify or discontinue the employee's weekly benefits.
This is a peek inside a courtroom at DIA, the Department of Industrial Accidents. It's a separate court system dedicated solely to resolving workers' compensation claims and handles about 12,000 new cases every year. Employees who say they've been hurt on the job face off with lawyers representing their employer's insurance company.
He hurt his right shoulder while lifting a heavy tote.
In this case, the insurance company doesn't believe it should have to keep paying workers' compensation benefits, but the employee's lawyer argues he's still injured.
He has extraordinary pain that gets up to 6-7 level out of 10.
All right, I'll take a look at everything. I'll get some out by the end of the week.
For a case to get to DIA, there's a dispute.
Correct, yes.
Someone
is not happy.
Omar Hernandez is senior judge at the Department of Industrial Accidents.
Do you see people trying to cheat the system?
I do not.
Hernandez says the majority of cases, including this one, are simply good faith disputes. But that's not always the case.
How big of a problem is workers' compensation fraud?
It is definitely a big problem here in Massachusetts.
Tony DiPaolo is vice president of investigations at the Insurance Fraud Bureau of Massachusetts, which shared recent cases with Five Investigates that relied on video surveillance.
So this is someone who's claiming he's too injured to work.
Correct. He says he can't work.
These three men cheated the system. All three were caught on video by insurance company investigators, and all three pleaded guilty in Massachusetts courts to larceny and workers' compensation fraud.
Two of the men actually first went to the Department of Industrial Accidents and lied to judges, claiming they couldn't work, including this man who was legitimately injured while working in a Massachusetts restaurant. 10 months later, he went back to work in another restaurant while continuing to collect workers' compensation benefits for his lower back injury for more than a year. Those fraudulent benefits added up to more than $31,000.
Very brazen, saying he can't work, telling the insurance company he can't work.
This man also misled a judge at the Department of Industrial Accidents and was eventually ordered to pay more than $100,000 in restitution. Once again, it started with a legitimate lower back injury.
He was going to different homes, going to hardware stores.
He collected both unemployment and workers' compensation benefits for a full year, all while operating his own construction company.
He says he can't work.
Right.
But that video shows something very different.
Clearly working, collecting money.
Judge Hernandez says it's disappointing and sheds a bad light on people who are actually hurt.
These are hard-working individuals who did not ask to be injured. And due to unfortunate circumstances, they were. And now you have others who are taking advantage almost on their back and trying to look for an easy ride.
The Department of Industrial Accidents tells us it's prohibited by law from tracking the number of cases of potential fraud that it encounters, but says anytime fraud is found, it's immediately referred for potential prosecution. Mike Beaudet, Five Investigates.